What makes Lagrima di Francisco Tarrega a sad piece? It begins and it ends in E major, so what is sad in it? Only the central part, something more. Let's see. Actually, the piece is beginning with a very simple melody. The melody actually is very simple, but listen carefully to what is coming now. The theory is Sting took a time machine, went some 90 years back in London of 1889, and inspired Tarrega writing. Anyway, in the first part, in the major part of Lagrima, we find a melody in the tenor, in the middle voice anyway, which is quite sad, which is this here. This little chromatic line has in some way to do with grieving, with crying, because since the Renaissance and the Baroque time, those chromatic lines that going downstairs are called passus duriusculus, which is a rhetorical figure, which means it's going quite hard. Anyway, let's hear all the first part. Second part in minor seems very much more to be adapted to express tearfulness and sadness, and there is some evidence of real crying in dissonances that we have right in the beginning of the second part. We have this E minor, especially important the B, because it's answered by a B, but this B is preceded by C. For a very brief moment, we have both the notes hearing, so this dissonance is quite tearful, to my opinion. And this C B we have in this answer of the second and third voice in the second bar of the second part. Okay, now a part this is actually quite heavily crying, because in the Renaissance, this could have been an exclamatio, a shout, a really cry of despair. Okay, so this part to me is very tearful. By the way, we have pieces in music that are very clearly called tearful, as Lacrimosa di Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart in the Requiem. We have in the very beginning of this Lacrimosa, we have quite these notes. I'll try to play this for you. We have exactly the same notes as Tarrega. Mm-hmm. I guess it's just the same or a similar idea. It's not that Tarrega copied from Mozart, but anyway, this is a point which is quite tearful. Yeah, that's are the most important points anyway, that to my opinion outline the sadness of this piece. By the way, a colleague of ours changed the keys, the minor in major and the major in minor, just for game, and it does work. But the first part in Lagrima, anyway, is like a sweet memory of something, of somebody, probably might be somebody who passed away. I read at some point that probably the piece has been inspired by the passing away of Tarrega's mother. If that is so, Tarrega must have a quite sweet memory of his mother, because this first part, anyway, is not too painful. Okay. Meanwhile, the second one Lacrimosa. Okay, thank you for watching. If you like it, please push the like button, subscribe to the channel, and if you have questions or comments, please leave them in the comments down below. Thank you very much. See you next time. Bye.